Students, today I am going to discuss about the introduction to lathe. So I'm going to discuss about this topic through one PPT. At first I want to tell what do you mean by lathe. Actually, lathe is called the father of all machines. Basically, this is not machine, this is called machine tool. That is a basic difference between a machine and machine tool. If we take an example of a machine, that is if we take an example of drill machine. In drill machine, we perform only one type of operation, that is drilling. That is why it is called machine. But in case of lathe, we can perform a several type of operations. Drilling, boring, turning, taper turning, facing, and many others. There are several parts in a machine. I will discuss later on this in my slides. I'm going to my next slide. That is types of lathe. There are several types: center lathe, tool room lathe, capstan turn lathe, automatic lathe. In our workshops, there is one type of lathe, that is center lathe. And in my lecture, I'm talking only about that type of lathe, that is center lathe. I'm going to my next slide, that is different parts of a center lathe. Okay, one thing I have already told, lathe is not called machine, this is called machine tool. Here one question arises. What is machine tool? Basically, we all know about the hand tools that we use during our workshop, like in our pattern or carpentry shop, fitting shop. There we can see different type of hand tools, and by using those hand tools we perform a job. But if we attach that hand tool into a machine, that will be converted in a machine tool. Suppose there is a hammer. We can strike anything, and that can be performed as a hand tool. But if we attach that hammer into a machine, it will be converted into a machine tool. It is also one type of machine tool, because different type of operations can be performed with this lathe. Okay, now I am coming again in my slide, that is different types of parts. In picture, we can see also different type of parts. In our left hand side, this is called our headstock, and the right hand side, this is called our tailstock, and the entire this section is called bed. Okay, and in the upper side of the bed, we can see the carriage. I'm coming about this in my next slide. And also here, the two parts are called legs. Or base or stand, anything. Yes, this is the entire picture of a lathe. We can see the different components or parts of a center lathe. That is, in our left hand side, this is called our headstock, this is called our tailstock, this is called the carriage, and in the carriage there are several parts. All the parts are shown in our picture. Another thing, that is chuck. Actually, chuck is not a direct part of a lathe. This is the attachment of headstock. The main function of this chuck is to hold our raw material, and we hold our cutting tool in this tool post section. And there are two rods. One is feed rod, another is lead screw. Both are also showing in our picture here. Now I am coming to my next slide, that is bed. Basically, bed is made of cast iron alloy with nickel, and the entire carriage and the weight that is located on this bed, and it have to carry the total weight. This is the main part of or lathe. Now I am going to my next slide, that is carriage. I have already told there are several parts, and it is used to move cutting tool along with the lathe bed. And in this picture also, we can see the several parts. Now I am going in detail, that is the components of carriage. In picture, also we can see there are several parts like saddle, cross slide, compound rest, tool post and apron. Those parts are shown in our picture clearly. Next slide is saddle. Already I have told, I am not going in detail about saddle. Just go through this slide. Next slide is cross slide. Again, just go through. I'm not going in detail about this. During any lathe operation, we have to operate this carriage, and then only we can see the functions of this parts. Next slide. That is tool post. This is also important thing that is in the carriage, because we have to hold our cutting tool. This tool post. Next slide. Apron. Again, please go through it. Okay. This is the tailstock. This is also important thing. Important part of a lathe. It is also called a dead stock, also, or dead center. There are several parts of tailstock. All the parts are shown in picture. Yes, these are the tailstock parts also written, that is dead center, tailstock spindle clamp, tailstock handle wheel, tailstock clamp lever, offsetting screw, etc. Slide. Yes, now question arises, what is the function of this tailstock? Because we are holding our job in our headstock through chuck. So what is the function of this tailstock? Actually, if our job is longer, then we have to hold our job through this tailstock. This is the main function to hold our job. Another thing is that the center of chuck and the tailstock lies on a same line. And we can use our tailstock to do some main operations like drilling, boring, tapping, rimming, etc. I'm going to my next slide. That is headstock. Yes, this is the most important part of our lathe. In the picture, we can also see this is the headstock, and in this portion, we have to attach our chuck, that is our holding device. In our headstock, all the gear arrangements are there. Okay, please go through the lines. I'm not reading all the lines. Okay, then I'm going to my next slide. It is work holding devices. I have already told about the work holding devices, that is chuck. Basically, there are two types of chucks, that is three-jaw chuck and four-jaw chuck. There are certain differences between these two types of chucks. In three-jaw chuck, we can see three jaws, and in four-jaw chuck, there are four jaws. Because in case of three-jaw chucks, the three jaws are self-centered. But in case of four-jaw chuck, this is not self-centered. The result, if we tight one jaw, then we have to adjust another three jaws in case of four jaw chuck. But in case of three jaw chuck, if we adjust any one jaw, then other jaws will be automatically adjusted. This is our basic advantage. If our work is in a regular shape or any cylindrical shape, so we can easily use our three jaw chuck. But in case of four jaw chuck, any irregular shape jobs we can use. Now please go through the lines. I'm not reading these lines. I am going to show my next slide, that is operations. There are several operations that we can perform through lathe. That is why we can call it the mother of all machines or machine tool. The operations are turning, taper turning, profiling, grooving, facing, face grooving, and others, other important operations like drilling, threading, knurling, etc. I'm going to prepare in my next video the basic operations of this lathe. Thank you very much.